All right. So yeah, no, I have been avoiding England. My reticence with monarchy take of England. I'm wondering why. You know, I've been there many times. I visited Scotland in the north. I visited Ireland, not the Northern Ireland, but I visited Ireland. Lived in Ireland. But when it comes to England, yeah, I've had a little bit of a longer stay there. I've huddled in the rain in a tent. I know what England is like rain-wise. It's kind of interesting. But more of anything in all my travels of Great Britain, Britannia there, Great Grossa Britannia, is the traffic. And then I'm like, well, you know, that's the way it goes. You know, they just spend day after day after day in those on those their congested arteries. So yeah, the traffic there is pretty much a terrible. Even in London, very much so, very terrible. So I don't know. Maybe that's just kept me away. Just kept me away. There's just not a quiet. There's not a quiet because of it. Because to go to, you know, a cultural arts event, you have to be in that traffic. So it's really, really a populated little island that way. It's very populated. Now, if you go north, you end up in the scoundrel zone of Scotland. You end up in the where it's just ooh, a little bit. Who are you? A stranger in our midst, type of thing. So you do end up with a little bit of a. I don't know. We don't know you. We don't know who you are. A lot of that locality goes on in that suspicious tone of Scotland. So even in that area, I have not found a great. Hey, I'm really happy to be a monarch of Scotland. I'm not. I haven't found a good attunement there with any of the people. I did visit Edinburgh. There's a university there. I did do some genealogy studies there, in their one of their libraries, and very, very interesting. It's a very interesting little college. So they do have good universities. They do have good study situations. They, of course, have history. You know, they have buildings and edifices of old and ancient architecture. And there is a love of the many of the people that really do have a respect for historical. They have a respect for historical improvements. That is one of the best things I can say about the English, is when it comes to historical improvements, they are, I think they beat everybody on the planet. I think they are wonderful. When it goes back through a house that's 500 years old, you know, there is somebody there that is recreating it again, that is in that exact same tone. That is not modernizing it. And there are those people that are really making that attempt. Now, of course, there are the others that are in the hurry for the fast cash. But all in all, there's still that group, that select group that knows how to maintain and keep a building in its true historical fashion. So yeah, I've been reticent with England. Nothing to do with big hay, they're big chippy eaters, nothing to do with that, nothing. Just I don't know. It's a set population. They've had their queen, and they really are set with their queen there. They won't understand my queen as a historical queen showing up. They have their particular So I have had a little reticence in taking England by storm, just by accumulation of data. Anyway, so when we're going through the fun of being this historical queen that is in full right to be monarch of England today. I did not mean to turn my back on you at all. I did not mean to turn my back. I did not mean to turn my back on your green spaces. I've driven by your green spaces, and my gosh, your green spaces are definitely green, and many times they are vast and just green and a disappointment. So we need to forest. We need to reforest those green spaces. And we need little groups over there also, just like the Forest Guardians, ones where you donate. And those little donation monies of $50 here, $100 there, $20, well, in pounds, 20 to 50 pounds, they buy trees. They buy trees, and those trees are planted. And it's just a beautiful thing. And so when you're driving by, you're on your M, whatever your M is, 67, when you're driving by, you gave to those Forest Guardians, and oh my goodness, look at that. There is a beautiful new forest that is happening. So that is really possible. That is something that I want to firstly give in my donation of information and expertise to England, is we need that recreation event of a beautiful donation group, the Forest Guardians. Okay. And get out there and plant, get out there and bring those brains to school. The same brains that learn. Good. You know me, I'm terrible with it. There was a beautiful tree out there, and it had a gorgeous look. And it probably wasn't an oak, and I stated it as an oak. It was probably something else, like a linden, or you know, I'm not good with it. You really need those types of studies to start reaching down into the younger groups, more appreciation, because we can do all these fun things like include the plastic bins in every store, those sealable plastic bins where you do the pouring out. Whether for it's for raisins, or if it's for grains, or graham crackers, those resealable bins, they save immensely on product replacement of recycled industry. You don't have to go there. You don't have to recycle those products again and again. You just use that plastic bin. It goes into a little sack, and then you refill at home into a container. It's very simple. It's been done, and it's been done, and that's what every store needs. That mandate has to happen in England. France has been very good. France pretty much has that, but I'm not sure about England. Okay. So, anyway, so yeah, let's make sure. Let's remember we are worldwide Forest Guardians. Let's make a worldwide donation group there, straight to England, straight to those green spaces. Okay, it's the only way we can increase the bird habitats. It's the only way we can create biodiversity that is, I don't know, just a beautiful rather than an ugly and a noise. Okay, signing off.